So first of all, here's the quote. Quote, "It seems like now is the time to say, I understand your pain. I want to comfort you. I think it's time we love each other. But the president took a different course. He said, I am the president of law and order, and he issued a heads up. He said, I'm ready to send in military troops if the nation's governors don't act to quell the violence that has rocked American cities. Matter of fact, he spoke of them as being jerks. You just don't do that, Mr. President. It isn't cool." End quote. And those were the words of Pat fucking Robertson. The man who once said that gay people had secret needles on the inside of their rings dipped in HIV-positive blood so that they could spite murder the straights with AIDS, thinks that Donald Trump could be a little bit more woke about how he's handling this shit. And look, we're going to talk about the bit where he ordered a park full of peaceful protesters to be gassed so that he could get a propaganda picture of him molesting a Bible like he was grabbing it by the pussy in the headlines. But I wanted to address this phenomenon we're seeing right now with a religious folks slowly coming over to the anti-Trump fold separately. Because I'm not buying the notion that these motherfuckers are just now noticing that Mr. 2 Corinthians is only using religion as a prop and is dangerous as hell to pretend otherwise. See, here's the thing. We're going to be tempted to forgive these motherfuckers. You know, a lot of people suddenly forgave George W. Bush for instituting an actual national torture policy and starting a war against the concept just because he said the right thing about Trump a few times. I'm worried we're about to do the same shit with a lot of the very same religious leaders that gave us President Donald Trump. And it's easy to see how it happens. Belatedly, they come our way. Some egregious action or another serves as either a catalyst or an excuse. And they say, why, now he's gone too far. Right. And whatever the action is, no matter how egregious, that moment is going to be hypocritical as all fuck. People who didn't turn against him when he locked children away from their parents and then lost them, you know, who continued to support him when he said neo-Nazis were very fine people, who stood by him when he tried to bribe a foreign leader into manufacturing evidence against his political rival with taxpayer dollars. These people are suddenly going to see the light and say, oh, but this was too much for me. And as artificial and convenient as that conversion is, there will be those of us who want to adopt a better late than never attitude and grit our teeth and welcome them with open arms. And by so doing, keep them in place for the next would-be tyrant they decide to suck off in hopes of getting a few more anti-abortion judges on the bench. Right now, again, a lot of people don't buy the concept here at all. Right, they see Pat Robertson's mild rebuke and these leaders condemning his biblical photo ops, and they see the same kind of tisk, tisk, tisk bullshit they saw when, like, Lindsey Graham gave him a stern talking to about the very fine neo-Nazi remark, or when Marco Rubio threatened to cut off his Tuesday hand jobs if he abandoned the Kurds. They feel like this sense of permanence, this sense that no amount of atrocious behavior and no amount of public disgrace could dislodge Republicans from their worship of Trump. And I just want to remind those people that before the ship starts sinking, getting rid of the rats seems impossible, too. You know, I don't claim everybody's going to jump ship here. Nothing in life is absolute. The same extremists that were the first to embrace his ass will be the last to let him go. There are a certain number of people in this country, especially amongst its religious leaders, that don't mind wearing their bigotry on their sleeve. But Trump didn't rise to power on the backs of extremists. There aren't enough of them for that to work. He got where he is because the mainstream of evangelical Christianity embraced him. The mainstream of conservative politics embraced him. The mainstream of Republican media embraced him. And those are the ones that are going to start rewriting history the soonest. When that starts to happen, it'll be real tempting to just celebrate any leak in the hole, right? The fucking threat from SS Trump was so omnipresent and so all-encompassing that any step towards alleviating it was going to inspire a sigh of relief. That's just natural. But let's not lose track of the fact that all those shipless rats swimming towards our boat saying they never liked Trump that much to begin with might have an ulterior motive for their conversion. Look, I've watched this play out before, and you have too. Most likely. I watched as a lot of people rewrote their support for George W. and pretended they agreed that torture was bad the whole time. Right? I'm watching many of those same fucking people rewrite their opposition to Obama. And if you think the abundance of on-record proof of the MAGA bullshit is going to dissuade any of these motherfuckers, you've obviously never presented evidence to a Christian before. Evangelical Christianity gave us Donald Trump. A lot of other things were involved, but it was that demographic of backwards bigots that made him a viable national candidate. What's more, they got what they wanted out of him. Any progress we were making towards a more inclusive nation has been arrested and rolled back. The judiciary is in their pockets for a fucking generation. A scapegoat too stupid to resist is willingly taking all the credit for the most reprehensible of their goals. And once he's gone, they're all going to look around, ask who the fuck that dude was and who the fuck invited him to the party, and tell us about the next great political candidate to come along. And if we don't tell them to go fuck themselves that time, we might not get another chance.